Harris, the great Mexican mask star, and Bull Ramos. Bull Ramos, a rugged individual who is now about to try to make their reputation by stopping Dos Caras. Dos Caras is solid, individual, flashy, sensational, like his brother, Mil Máscaras. He has an international reputation. So with referee Juan Reynosa, the man in the ring, you see Dos Caras looking to land on Bull Ramos, and Bull Ramos just wasn't there. He knows that he better not be when the projectile starts coming down to his broad, expansive middle. Full Nelson is the hold. Dos Caras applying it. Now, these fellows are fighting to be eligible and named by the tournament committee to be in tonight's final event of this great, wild, and wonderful weekend of wrestling that ends its third night tonight at the Sam Houston Coliseum, starting at 8 o'clock. The Battle Royal at 8 o'clock is going to be one of the feature events. We suggest that you get on hand early tonight. And the matches will move smoothly and quickly through the night until one man remains unbeaten. Dos Caras would like to be that man. But then so would Bull Ramos. So as Bull Ramos tries to convince referee Juan Reynosa that he was taken unfair advantage of by the masked man, he then looked for an opportunity to sneak in there and do something about it. Now, the matches you are seeing this morning, and you will see some great ones, this one, and you will see a great battle between Tully Blanchard and Mike Graham. What a sensational match you're going to enjoy. It's part of what took place in the Sam Houston Coliseum on Friday night as the opening events of the great tournament took place. And that was a drop kick that came up there. You could hardly see Dos Caras, but right now he's making sure that you see him and that Bull Ramos gets to see him. And Bull Ramos was just introduced to the ring post right here in front of us, and Ramos is mad as he grabs hold of a chair and starts to sashay back into the ring, and somebody attempted to stop him and got him a little upset. The Bull, here comes Caras, who's trying to meet trouble head on. And, well, chair was just knocked apart against the ring post, and half of it is in the hand of Dos Caras. Oh, he comes down there with a beautiful smash if you're a Dos Caras fan. And as he turns on Juan Reynosa, these fans are just bloodthirsty enough to want to convince Dos Caras that they'd like to see him hit the referee. But you can't take your eyes off a guy like Bull Ramos. He's had too much wrestling experience. And right now, as he crowds Dos Caras and moves him into the ropes on that far side of the ring, he suddenly finds that Caras can fight his way back. There you're looking at one of Mexico's top stars and the man who tonight in the Coliseum hopes to be able to extend his reputation and extend it for sure. He has a lot of wrestling skills, and Bull Ramos is adept at the art of trying to throw a guy off the track. Listening to the roar of this crowd. Next Sunday, we will be back again with Southwest Championship Wrestling at this same hour, but wrestling you see tonight is, this morning rather, is Houston wrestling, and we are telling you that it will be
5 minutes,
a harbinger of things to take place at the Coliseum tonight. So bouncing Ramos on the canvas is a great way to take the pep out of him. But as he rolls underneath that rope, Ramos is looking for some way that he can even things and maneuver back into the into the ring. Ramos here took exception to saw what somebody did to him out on the outside of the ring that time, and it was about to go up the aisle when he had to stop and take care of Dos Caras. The give and take. You've got a huge man, and that huge man is trying to force the pressure of his hands and the pressure of his fingers down into the hollow of the neck up there at the trapezius muscle, and he is able now to force the masked man down onto the canvas. There is a count of one and a count of two. Ramos on top with his more than 300 pounds is able to force Dos Caras into a difficult situation. But Caras found his mark that time and found it well. And through the ropes and on the floor goes the Bull, and again he maneuvers over to a spot where he can get some reinforcements. So the Bull's got a chair, but he had no intention of sitting on it. As Caras, I thought Caras was going to come over that top rope, but he was smart. He was waiting for Bull to come close enough. And then when he knew he wasn't going to be able to kick him, they decided that he would come over that top rope and do something about it. Following up is the Bull, managing to crash it in there, twisting arm lock for Ramos. The twist is good. Ramos has a solid grip on that hold, and of course Dos Caras is a heavyweight, so even though he is outweighed, he is in his right class. He can take care of people from 200 pounds to 500 pounds, and Bull Ramos is trying to lessen Dos Caras' weight by biting off some of his fingers, and those fans are telling referee Juan Reynoso not how the cow ate the cabbage, but how the bull ate the fingers. Trouble for Dos Caras. Bull Ramos covering it up from the referee, and that can be excruciatingly painful. That elbow flashing through the air and finding Dos Caras. He's gonna have trouble there. That's the way to fight his way out of trouble. And as the masked man moves in, he's got a head to pop, and he's after it. Just remember, our ticket office at 1919 Caroline is open right now as you watch this. And tickets for this final night of this sensational tournament are available at 1919 Caroline. They are also available at the box office at the Coliseum tonight. The box office opens at 6 o'clock. Nice move by Dos Caras, and he makes the switch. Makes the switch beautifully. Quick turn and the drive in there. And as Bull backs away, you see Dos Caras moving in to do something about it. It's now, the Bull hit here and almost broke.
10 minutes.
Hard driving maneuver. Here goes Bull Reynolds trying to fall on him again. And now Dos Caras, as he moves in, moves to get after him. The setup, and as Caras moves in, he tries to maneuver across that ring. The dive, and down goes the Bull, and the so as they maneuver outside, here comes Dos Caras. The blocking of the effort into the ring post, and as the head of the Bull come down there, we see Dos Caras ready to spring off, and he does. Right. We've got a fall. Dos Caras takes it.
The winner for 11 minutes, 20 seconds, Dos Caras.
Mr. Norman has a word for you right now. Let's listen.